नमस्ते एवरीवन, दिस इज संतोष साबत. वेलकम टू माय चैनल साबत एकेडमी. सो व्हाट वी विल सी टुडे हियर इज वील सी फर्स्ट अबाउट द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री. बट बिफोर बिगिनिंग विद दैट वी शुड नो व्हाट आर एंगल्स एंड हाउ टू मेजर एंगल्स. सो इन दिस वीडियो व्हाट वी विल सी इज एंगल एंड इट्स मेजरमेंट, राइट. सो वेरी फर्स्ट थिंग विच वी वुड सी इज व्हाट इज एन एंगल. व्हाट इज एन एंगल? So basically angle it's a measurement of rotation. So what we assume is, so there is a reference line, or we also called it as initial ray, right? Or in some textbooks they define it as initial side. So this is our reference line, and what we do is we rotate this. So there is a fixed point about which it rotates, right? So this is called vertex, and this is initial ray or side. Now what we measure, so what is basically angle is the measurement of rotation. So how much this initial ray rotates, and then it goes to a final, like final ray, or we call it as terminal ray. We call it as terminal ray or side. So basically what is an angle? So it is basically the amount of rotation required to reach this terminal angle if we start from this initial ray or initial side. So the amount of rotation required to reach the terminal side when we start from the initial side is basically our angle theta. So that is how we define the angle, right? Okay. Now, once we have defined the angle, now how do we measure it? So before measuring, suppose this is our initial ray, right? And when I rotate, so I can rotate in anti-clockwise sense or I can rotate in clockwise sense, right? So when we rotate in anti-clockwise sense, we consider that rotation or that angle value to be positive. When we rotate in a clockwise sense, we consider that rotation angle to be negative value, right? Okay. So now suppose if I consider this as initial ray, right, and when I rotate and when I come back to the same point, that means my initial side is same as the terminal side, right? So that rotation, when we rotate the initial side, when it comes back again to the terminal side, we call that as one revolution, right? So we call that as one revolution. Now based on this, we define the unit in which we measure the rotation. So that unit is degree. So how we define the degree? So basically in one revolution, what we are doing is we are moving the initial side, we are rotating the initial side, and we are coming back to the same terminal side. Now this is called 360 degree. So how do we define 1 degree, or basically 1 degree, how do we define? We define it as, it is 1/360th part of a revolution. It is 1/360th part of a revolution. 1/360th part. So that is 1 degree. Right. And we also know 1 degree can also be written as 60 minutes, and 1 minute can also be written as 60 seconds. So these are conversion from degree to minutes, minute to seconds, right? So now that is what you must have studied in your school also. Now, in your like from 11th onwards, what we do is we measure degree, we measure the angles not in degree, rather we measure in radians. Why? Because the SI unit of plane angle, is radian. Okay. And the symbol is RAD. So this is the symbol. Right? So we should know how much is 1 radian. So how much is 1 radian? That is the question, right? So we'll see. So what we can do is we can consider a circle. We can consider a circle of say radius R. So what we are doing is we are considering a circle of radius R, right? And so this is a circle of radius R. When the length of the arc, if I assume there is an arc, right? And if the length of the arc is to be same as that of R, so this is R and the length of arc is also R and the radius is also R. So this angle, this rotation or this measure of angle can be defined as 1 radian. So how do we define 1 radian? So basically it is the angle subtended at the center of a circle, at the center of a circle when the length of arc is same as radius. That is why it is called radian. When the length of the arc is same as radius, so that angle subtended at the center is called 1 radian. So we write it as 1 RAD in physics, and in maths we also write it as 1 radian. Or even if we don't write this symbol C, that is fine. So we can also write 1, right? Because if there is no degree sign, that means it is radian. So angle measured is in radian. Okay. Now, so this was the definition of 1 radian, right? So what is the definition of 1 radian? We'll again see quickly. So basically 1 radian is an angle subtended at the center of a circle when the length of arc is equals to radius, right? Now suppose if I consider a unit circle, that means a circle of radius 1 unit, and this is a circle of assume radius 1 unit, and the length of arc is also 1 unit. So when the length of arc is 1 unit in a unit circle of say in a circle of unit radius, when the length of arc is 1 unit, then that angle is also called 1 radian. So basically it is RRR, and here it is 1 1 1, right? So length of arc is 1 unit, then we can say the angle subtended by that length of arc at the center is 1 radian. Fine. So till now we saw what is the definition of 1 radian. Now we will see what is the relation between radian and degree. So we will derive the relation. So suppose if I consider a unit circle or a circle of say radius R. Okay. So we know, how do we define 1 radian? If the length of arc is R, so that is how we define 1 radian, right? So consider this as A, B and C, and center as O, right? Okay, measure angle AOB corresponds to R, right? Now, how much measure angle AOC corresponds to? So if I write measure angle AOC, so we know as it's a semicircle, so semicircle means the length of the semicircle is, perimeter is pi R, right? So if I take the ratio of measure angle AOB to the measure angle AOC, what do I get is R upon pi R. So therefore what I get is measure angle AOB is equals to 1 by pi times measure angle AOC. So we know what is measure angle AOC. So it is a semicircle, so in degree it will be 180 degree, And just now we defined measure angle AOB is 1 radian, right? Because the length of arc is same as radius. Therefore, 1 radius, 1 radian is equals to 1 by pi or 180 degree by pi. So, therefore, if I take the pi here, what will I get is pi radian is equals to 180 degree. So, this is the relation between degree and radian. Pi radian is equals to 180 degree. Okay. So, this relation you will use for your entire future in any branch of engineering or any branch of sciences you go, this relation you will always use, pi radian is equals to 180 degree. Fine. Now, just now we saw how much is 1 radian. So, it is 180 degree by pi, right? So, if I want to know how much is x radian in degree, so simply I have to multiply by x, right? So, that will give me in degrees. And we have pi radian is 180 degree. So, if I want 1 degree, how much will be that? That will be pi by 180 radian. So, if I want x degree in radian, so simply I have to multiply by x. Right? So, that means if you have something in radian, you can just put in this right hand side, you will get the value in degree. If you have something in degree and if you want something in that same thing in radian, you have to put this here, you will get. Fine. So, that was the relation between radian and degree, and also we saw the conversion formula.